Stormwater analysis is a little complex, but not because it's particularly challenging, but that there's just so many little steps along the way. And once you go to a different county, they completely change how they do it. But I thought I'd go through a single stormwater analysis project in hopes of highlighting where these differences exist, but then walking you through how it's done in one particular location. So this particular project that I'm going to show you is the conversion of an old abandoned car dealership into a multifamily residential project. We're going to be using in this project Google Earth, as you can see here, and we'll utilize these tools to show us the location of our project, all the adjacent stormwater facilities, the soil conditions, the precipitation maps, and everything. You can see here the project is located at the corner of Foothill Boulevard and Bradford Street. If you click on the date at the bottom left corner, you can bring up past imagery. So this is what the site looked like when it was a fully fledged operational car dealership. As the credit crisis hit, the car dealership was left abandoned for a couple of years, and then later plans came along from this particular investment group to convert the car dealership into multifamily housing and a commercial area. Construction on this site started around the beginning of 2013 and ultimately finished a year later in 2014. So this is our project site. To comply with local stormwater guidelines, there were a number of stormwater facilities planned for this project site. I'm providing you in this file the boundary line here that's all shown in blue is the boundary line. I'm also providing to you the proposed drainage facility. So if I go under the file and I expand the folder out underneath under final project, you'll be able to see here the developed facilities. If I check that box, you'll see the 8 different surface inlets that convey stormwater runoff generated on-site into pipelines that then convey the flow to the 2 highlighted yellow stormwater BMPs. Those pipelines connect each of the surface drains down to the BMPs before then they ultimately drain into the storm drain located in Foothill Boulevard. So you can see here, drop inlet 3 will get conveyed into a pipe which then discharges into the BMP. This area here, the eastern area of the project, 5 and 6 and 7 combined to a pipe that then drops into the stormwater best managed practice here highlighted in yellow. And same with inlet 8. So I know I said every stormwater analysis is different. They do tend to follow some general workflow for each project site. And that's what I'm going to go over with you right now. The general steps that you do on every stormwater analysis. The first big chunk of work that you do is basic research. You want to create a location map. You want to know what other existing stormwater facilities there are nearby. You need to know what precipitation data there is for your project site, and of course the soils data for your project site. Once all of that is gathered, take a few moments and write up a summary about it. It should be pretty quick. The second big chunk of tasks can be done at the same time or in parallel as the first chunk, and this is creating a drainage map for the pre-developed conditions, writing a summary about it, and creating a drainage map for the developed conditions and writing a summary about it. So if you're working in a team, these tasks can be divided up and worked on in parallel and help complete the project much quicker. The third chunk of tasks is the hydrologic analysis. For this work, you'll build upon all of the previous tasks and use that to find the time of concentration and create the peak flow analysis calculation for both the pre-developed and the developed conditions, and then do the first flush analysis, followed by a written summary of all of those results. The final chunk of work builds upon everything that's been completed, takes the hydrologic analysis that was completed, and applies that to the proposed facilities at your site. This includes, for example, computing the depth and velocity of flow in each drainage swale on the surface, finding the size of each inlet, for example, the curb inlets and the area drains. How big do those need to be? What size of pipe needs to convey the flow from the inlets to the BMPs? How big does a BMP need to be in terms of volume? And of course, a BMP in this situation is a detention basin. So then what size of outlet do you need for the detention basins? And of course, all along the way, write about your results. Don't wait till the very end here where you are trying to play catch up and being overwhelmed with the writing. So my hope with this series of videos is to walk you through each one of these steps, giving you the confidence you need to do your own stormwater analysis.